Good morning and welcome to my video. Today's video is on Comprehensive Addiction and Recovery Act. My name is Laura. Happy to discuss more about the policy. Let's begin. Let's talk about the epidemic that opioid overdose has caused in the United States. Since the 1999 to 2017, there has been more than 100,000 people that have died from around 68% of these 70,000 drug overdose deaths. In because of in 2017, the number of overdose deaths have been because of opioids, and which was about 6 times higher than in 1990. On average, 130 Americans die every day from opioids. As you can see, this is an epidemic. There has been 3 waves in the opioid overdose deaths. First wave came in 1999, when there was rising prescription opioid overdose deaths. As you can see, this rise right here came through. And in wave two, as you can see, in 2010, there was a high rise in overdose deaths through heroin. As you can see, this steep incline. And now, the wave that we are in is the rise in synthetic opioid overdose. And that's the one that's been increasing these deaths. We're going to discuss about the age-adjusted rate of drug overdose in 2017. We see that it's 9.6% higher than the rate in 2016. And among the when we analyze these results, we find out that ages from 25 to 54 are the ages with higher rates of drug overdose deaths. As you can see it in this picture right here, it shows you a graph of what the ages have become. So that's the 100,000 population. The strategy of this CARA Act was to increase the funding so that there can be more prescription drug monitoring programs, medication assisted treatment programs addressing youth or juvenile substance abuse programs, as well as comprehensive abuse, opioid abuse response. It will also self-evaluate by putting measures to making sure that these programs are working effectively. This bill will also help the veterans by increasing the importance of the mental health and substance abuse by making them go into a qualification process and seeing if there's a high risk of these veterans to be abusing the substances. More provisions will be made in the criminal justice system as a result of these changes. And lastly, one of the most significant changes will be access to naloxone treatment. It's really important as this drug is used for reversal of the opioid overdose. First responders will be given the appropriate training to the naloxone administration. And this way, all law enforcement and first responders can help save lives at the end of the day and end the crisis. When you look at the evaluative criteria, we can see that politically, there have already been so many other appropriate actions that have been taken by other states before the federal came out with this law. Washington was the second state that allowed legal possession of naloxone to anyone at risk of having or witnessing an opioid overdose. This was in 2012, and they saw the they had a drug monitoring program. They saw how it helped. They were able to show the criteria, or they were able to show the results of where all the opioid drugs are going, and it helped create legal possession of naloxone as a result, and help avoid the opioid overdose crisis that's been happening, or help reduce the burden. Although federal government has been absent during the opioid crisis, hopefully this bill has been showing promising new implementation in regions that need help. Epidemiologically speaking, since 2016 to 2017, there has been an increase in opioid overdose by 35%. The highest was seen in Wisconsin, Illinois, Delaware, and Texas. This requires that all state of your order, surveillance is important in this situation, because if we can see where each state, which state is at most, is hitting the epidemic the most, and we can kind of shape our funding based on each state. This is something that Cara failed to address. Ethically speaking, doctors will be able to provide opioids, but only to the people that need it the most. And this can be a problem because people, doctors, for example, in rural area, there's less doctors to begin with. So if these doctors are prescribing a lot of prescription drugs, then it's unfair to them, and there's more patient to physician ratio. And so drugs like buprenorphine can cause cannot be prescribed as often for the needed population, and people can end up suffering through more pain. Legally speaking, CARA is an act that increased restrictions for doctors. And this can be a problem because, for example, one of the biggest problems is the pharmacy and prescriber locking programs as a result of prescription drug programs. This can help restrict. This restricts patients to go to different pharmacy stores or different prescribers and trying to get the same drugs, same opioid drugs. It's a good thing so that people don't abuse these drugs, but it's also a bad thing for people that travel for work and take prescription drugs for their long journey. There has been alternatives such as the 21st Century Cures Act of 2016 and the Addiction Treatment and Access Act of Cures Act has been used as a tool at the same time as the Comprehensive Addiction Recovery Act, but their goal was to provide funding for each state. This way, there can be more community-specific action to fight against addiction. In addition, this Cures Act also has increased funding towards cancer-related research as well, and this was a way to finding a cure to ending life-ending illnesses, hoping to reduce the use of opioid patients as a result. As a result of this DPA Act, we were able to close the gap that the CARA created, where it was not able to reach the state as needed, that we discussed earlier, in terms of helping fight. ATAI Act is actually one of these acts that revises the administration of dispensing prescribing narcotics by increasing the eligibility status of non-practitioner prescribers. So this way, for example, midwives spend so much time with the pregnant women and infants, and many of these pregnant women and infants are affected by prenatal substance exposure. As a result, midwives should be given access to administrating, dispensing, and prescribing narcotic drugs as needed, for example, buprenorphine. And in CARA Act, that was not stated, that they were not allowed to have access to those medications, to those prescribed opioid drugs. ATAI was used to help us and try to allow many additional non-prescription practitioners to have access to medication. Recommendation for CARA is creating alternative and affordable treatment options, as compared to just simply increasing the access. But that's not enough. We gotta create more affordable and provide different options. Addiction is a disease, and that should be created decriminalized. So the more awareness we reach out, the more awareness we create to show that addiction is a disease, and it's only a disease, it's not a crime. It's more people will come forward and try to have more treatment possible for this. The harms to patients, harms to pain, patients in older states, there can be a possible place where hospitals can have shortages of these drugs, and that can cause many people, many prescribers to prescribe different medications which are not as good as these opioids, and that can end up causing more errors in the system, as well as these as a result, like this law needs to find a balance between providing necessary medication for the ones in need versus restricting the opioid use. Temptation is that with the cap on the number of physicians, as I mentioned before, people in rural areas, for example, where there's physician shortages, ratio of physicians patients are pretty low in this case. You know, the ratio between patients to physicians is high, and as a result, we gotta make sure that we can balance this out for those physicians in particular. With the growing elderly population, this becomes another epidemic because higher number of opioids is needed for these patients, and as a result of this, we gotta make sure that we create a balance between both restricting and allowing. Conclusion is that this act is the beginning of the end of an epidemic of an opioid overdose, and it has shown to provide promise. With improvising upon its policies through its evaluation of the program, we can eventually create a highly effective system to end the epidemic. Some of my references.